Hey, Roz.
Hi, Martin. I'm really sorry to hear about your friend, Maury.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, his wife just did the nicest thing. I guess she knew that Eddie and I had stopped by and shoot the breeze with him, so she gave us something to remember him by.
Well, for Martin and Eddie, gee, isn't that nice?
Yeah, I think it's some kind of wine.
Well, yes, I'd say so, but... My God, Dad, this is a 1945 Chateau Petrus.
Oh, yeah? She said he got it from his uncle who was in France after the war.
But it's one of the rarest bottles in the world.
Well, if you're good, maybe Eddie will give you a glass out of his half.
I've never even seen a 45 Petrus.
Oh, poor Maury. He probably waited his whole life for an occasion special enough to open that bottle.
Perhaps this should be a lesson for us all. Maury may be standing guard at the door to heaven right now, but he's buzzing us with one last message. Live life now. I'm reminded of a parable.
Come in.
Simon!
Oh, sis.
I thought you were in California.
Yeah, well, those friends I went to surprise were out of town, so I decided to house it for them, which was lovely. Till they came home last night. I don't know what all the screaming was about. I was the one in the tub. Where should I put this bag?
By the door so you don't forget it when you leave.
Right. Well, I think I know everybody here. Or do I? What would your name be then, miss?
Simon, you low-life idiot. You made a date with me last week and you stood me up.
Sorry, love, I need a bit more to go on.
Maybe this will refresh your memory.
Roz, of course.
Daph, you know, I'm glad you're here because I was thinking about that wine of Maury's, you know. That's something really for a special occasion. So I'd like you to have it for the wedding. Enjoy it on your honeymoon.
Oh, Mr. Craig.
Oh, Daphne, come on now. It's only a bottle of wine. I don't even know much about it. Frazier, help me out here, will you?
Well, Dad, the Chateau Petrus is a premier cru Bordeaux.
No. I mean, but Daphne, there you go.
Oh, dear. Oh.
I'm sorry to get so emotional like this.
That's all right. Yes, the funeral must have really upset you.
It's not that. Dr. Crane, I've wanted to talk to you about this all week, but I haven't known what to say. Can you promise you'll keep this just between us?
Of course.
It's about your brother. You see, I know.
Know what?
I know about his feelings for me.
My God! How did you find out?
It's not important.
Somebody blabbed, didn't they? Why can't people just mind their own business? Who was the nattering gossip? Roz? Dad?
You.
What?
You were taking those pills for your back and you blurted it out while I was giving you a massage.
Oh, well, they were very strong pills, you see.
Needless to say, it completely took my breath away. At first, I tried to forget about it, put it out of my mind.
Yes, well, the bottle said it'd take just one, but you know, I'm a big man.
You shut up about those pills.
I'm sorry, Daphne.
Anyway, after a while, I couldn't put it out of my mind anymore. I find myself thinking about him all the time.
Daphne, are you saying that you have feelings for Niles?
I think I do. Oh, I don't know. Even if I did, he may not feel that way about me anymore. He's with Mel now.
I don't know what to tell you, Jeff. I think that the best thing is to try to find a way to talk with Niles.
Oh, that's not an easy conversation to have.
It's easier now than after you're married.
You're right. I have to talk to him, and right away. I'm already making myself sick over this. If I leave it any longer, I'll be a complete basket case. Did he mention if he was going home?
Well, actually, he's going somewhere else first.
Where?
Get you some towels, and you'll be all set now.
Right.
Oh, jeez, Daphne, it's just a bottle of wine.
You've always been such a wonderful friend. In fact, I brought this for the honeymoon, but I'd like you to have it.
Oh, Daphne, I couldn't.
Donnie and I aren't wine drinkers.
I wouldn't dream of it, really.
All right, I'll keep it.
No, I've hurt your feelings here. Oh, gosh, Daphne. Tell you what, I promise that when I do drink this, I'll be thinking of you.
Oh, come here.
Oh, Jeff.
There's my baby.
Mummy! Mum, this is...
Oh, I know who he is, love. I want to thank you, Donnie, for rescuing my daughter from that horrible Dr. Crane. Every time I call her, I'm not on the phone 5 minutes before that tyrant is ordering her to hang up. Cup of tea, please. Thought my daughter might get me one, but she didn't. Oh, God, this seat's worse than the Winnebago. Though not half as uncomfortable as that sardine tin of a room you arranged for me. Oh, God. Can't even bear the smell of that. Take it away.
Oh.
Reminds me of the salmon they served on the aeroplane. Oh, if it doesn't have me hurling me guts out, it'll be by God's own intervention. Now, give your new mum a kiss, Donnie.
Oh, actually, Mum, this isn't Donnie.
Oh. Wait, is this Mum? Yeah,
this is Donnie.
Hi.
Well, come here. Let's have a look at you. We were starting to think our Daphne would never find herself a young man. And I see she hasn't. What beggars can't be choosers. Well, I'm going to go and see if your father's stomach is feeling any better. He keeps saying it's tension. What he's got to be tense about, I'll never know.
I was worried she'd be in one of her dark moods.
Hey, Niles.
Don't tell me the ceremony's over already.
Oh, no, it hasn't even started yet.
Actually, we saw you heading over this way. We thought maybe you could use some company.
I just felt like some privacy.
Mm.
This is one wedding I couldn't see myself handling very well.
Oh, lots of people cry at weddings.
Mm. Yeah, but not so many end up wailing and rending their garments. No, I appreciate your coming over, but I'd hate for you to miss it on my account.
Well, actually, it's been delayed a bit. You see, the Justice of the Peace started out asking the witnesses to step forward. Three of Daphne's brothers just ran off into the woods.
Hello.
Here's your wine, sir.
Yes, thank you very much, young man. This is for you. Thank
you. What is this?
Well, now, I got to thinking about our old friend Maury and how he kept this bottle of wine his entire life, waiting for a special occasion. And then I thought, what occasion am I saving it for? And then I thought about what a courageous thing you did last night. Taking that chance. And that's worth a toast.
No, no, Fraser.
No, no, it's too late. Foil's pierced.
I know this thing between you and Mel seems kind of bad right now, but...
Oh, no, Dad, why do you say that? Just because I spent the third night of my marriage proposing to another woman?
Well, I'm just saying that marriage can survive all kinds of stuff, you know? You might still be happy. 10 years from now, this could all be ancient history.
I hope you're right.
All right, gentlemen. Here we are now. Dad, no one else. Allow me to better days.
Dad, where did Maury keep this?
In his wine rack.
Which is?
In the boiler room.
Oh, Lord. I'll just save this little treat for later.
Yes, well, thanks for the thought. You two should be running along. I'll be fine.
All right, well, take care, Miles.
Thanks, Dad.
No, I saw a waiter passing champagne just outside. I'll have him bring you a glass so you can
get the taste out. Yes, yeah. Thank you, Fraser.